Alright, it is Monday again, and the post office is actually closed today, but I'm going to still get items ready, just to have them ready to go for tomorrow. It's Columbus Day, is why it's closed. So over the weekend, I sold 11 items for an average price of $43 each. I'm pretty happy with that. One of the items, especially, was a higher end, higher price. It is that Korg X2 keyboard piano, the one that I fixed like a month or so ago. Now, I had it listed for $500. But because it's just so big and I just want to get rid of it, I accepted an offer for $200 plus whatever the shipping is. Definitely not as high as I would like, but just the fact that I don't have this sitting around the room anymore is worth it, and there's still a profit there. Here's what sold.
This is the Korg X2.
This is a Bell System telephone. This is not the original receiver, but this is the Imperial Gold. I used to sell a lot more telephones like this. I don't buy them or really find them or sell them often anymore. This one took about a year to sell, which is exactly why I don't do this much. But it sold for, I think, around $20-$25. A Craftsman 7.2 volt, 9.6 volt industrial 1 hour charger. This is a Denon RC883 remote. Now this sold for $45 and it only sold that low, which is incredibly high for just a controller because it does not have the battery cover. Now if this had the battery cover, I think this would sell for more, around $75 to $80. This is the Light Force Therapy. You put different colored lights on your skin and some people believe that helps you. Maybe it does, I don't know. Kind of seems fake to me. This is a Polaroid Sun 600 LMS camera. This sold to a bigger camera company that actually buys a lot of my Polaroids. And I think this sold for about $35. A pair of Kate Spade sunglasses. They have a few real light scratches on them, nothing major. These sold for $20. This is a Yamaha pedal. I'm not sure if it's supposed to be a sustain pedal or, what's the other one? I don't know, but a keyboard pedal. This is a C7 light strand. I bought quite a bit before Christmas last year and sold through most of them, but I still have a few remaining and expect them to sell out in the next month. An electric toothbrush charging base. And lastly, a lot of 22 neat looking nails. Sold this for $10. They look a little special to me. I'm not sure if they actually are, but somebody did think so as well. All right, I got all those packaged, but I still have this keyboard, which is big and heavy and awkward. So I think I'm gonna do it out there. Now I do not have a box that is big enough to fit this, so I'm going to have to make it out of like four or five different boxes. Kind of show you the process of making a box out of a box.
I'm in my little box room, don't look at me. I'm not who I ought to be. I don't want to be together. I wanna be by myself forever. 1, 2, 3, 4, counting them out. I got words flying out of my mouth. I beg your pardon, I was born in a garden. So send a salami to the boy in the army. I'm in my little box room, don't look at me. I'm not who I ought to be. I don't want to be together. I wanna be by myself forever. Life is a bitch and she cheats on me. But I cheat in her too constantly. To get my cake and I eat it too.
I made Frankenstein boxes countless times, but I don't know if I've ever made five boxes into one box before.
You wanna be at mine, I know, but I gotta tell you this is really fun. Friday nights are lonely, I'm sure. I wouldn't wanna be where you are.
To be
mistakes with this box, and I now realize how I should have built it, but I don't have the right kind and the enough boxes to do so. So I'm just going to continue on with the way I am doing it, and it's going to work, but I'm just going to need a lot of tape, basically. A lot more tape than I've already used, and I've used a bunch. I'm not very proud of this packing job, but it will work. Alright, it's finished. I told Haley as I was starting this that I bet this is going to be an hour job. And, yep, 1 hour and 2 minutes right now. That was really a lot of work. And, I mean, it's only going to Las Vegas, so it doesn't have a real far way to go. It is sturdy. It just looks like junk. But I'm happy to have that taken care of so I don't have to worry about rushing tomorrow morning to get that ready for the post office. It will already be good to go. So surprisingly, it is it's 42 pounds and 5 ounces, 51 by 18 by 12 inches, and surprisingly, that only costs $40.69 to ship, which is great because shipping paid by buyer was $52.58, so a little bit extra for taking that lower price. So last week I got a pass to Portland's Adidas employee store, which gives you 50% off of everything in the store. And I needed new shoes, so went there and I got this pair right here, all black, pretty nice. They were 90 and I got them for 45, and figured I don't really want to pay 45 for them, so I got another pair. This one is in size 12. They're not for me, they're to sell online in size 12 just because larger sizes usually sell better, and I think I can sell these for about $69 to $79, so all in all I will get this pair of shoes for what, like $20 or $30. The new versus old. Cool. Stepped in dog shit within 5 minutes or less of putting them on. So we are starting to prep for filming on Sunday. Today is Friday night. I went and picked up this fabric a couple days ago. It's for some of the cult members that are going to be in the movie. And the black one is for the monster. We just cut the white ones to size. Yeah, just kind of doing small things to prep to get a little bit closer to it. So we're not rushing last minute. For a lot of the house, we're just kind of going to declutter and minimalize. Like all the stuff that's on the fireplace mantle, we're going to get rid of that, except for the, what is that, a deer skull? For the devil skull. And most of the decorations are going to come down, and this whole area right here is going to at least look a lot more minimal. So it's going to be kind of, in a way, spring cleaning. Alright, just about a day has passed and we're going to make more motions to get ready for this video shoot tomorrow. Need to minimize, I think I already talked about this, but pretty much the rest of the day is just going to be preparing for this shoot. So, time lapse. We'll be right back. Okay, just got back from two different grocery stores to get everything that we need for tomorrow. Oreo is doing a mystery flavor thing where I guess you guess the flavor and enter a contest. And, I don't know, but I got it and I wanted to see if we can guess it.
We're here.
Yeah. What's going on in here? Knocked over.
Most of them are broken. Mm-hmm. Just like lemon pie, maybe?
Maybe like lemon meringue or something? No.
Lemon pie. Lemon. I like it. Yep.
I like it, Rob.
No?
Good thing you can have carbs again.
Next time you see us, we're going to win this $50,000. Okay, so the two next things that I need to do to get ready is make fake blood and then boil these turkey drumsticks. Now this turkey drumsticks has the skin on it, and I'm going to use it for a close-up shot of somebody biting and ripping flesh. I want to make sure to get the skin on so it would hopefully look a little bit more realistic instead of just having just the flesh. I don't know, I think it will be alright. Now I've made a lot of different fake bloods over the past, 10 years or so, and a lot of them have used corn syrup and cocoa powder or chocolate sauce, and then of course like red food coloring, and I always use a little bit of green just to get, because red is just, it's just too red, so you use a little bit of green to try to get that perfect blood color. The problem is with corn syrup is it is super sticky and very uncomfortable when it's on your skin. So I just found a new recipe which involves one tablespoon of flour per one cup of water, and you boil that for about 30 minutes and then add the food coloring after that. And hopefully it works because it's kind of late and I don't have corn syrup. I already went to the store and I did not get it. Alright, so the mixture has came to a boil, and now I turned down the stove to the lowest setting, and I'm just gonna let it kind of simmer and cool. Well, not cool, but simmer for the next 25 minutes. Alright, so next step is these turkey drumsticks. I remember eating a turkey drumstick last summer at some sort of like Renaissance fair, and I thought it was gonna be awesome. But it was really gristly. One of these I'll eat. The other, a monster will eat. There we go. Let those boil and hopefully the skin doesn't shrink or do anything dumb. Mabel knows the meat's cooking. Hanging out and waiting for a chance to get something maybe. Actually, I think I normally use a little bit of blue, not green. There we go. Alright, so turkey is done at 165 degrees. Stick this kind of in the thickest part. Alright, so I hit 165. This one right here is just a little bit bigger, so I'm going to go ahead and just cook them both. I don't know, maybe another 5 minutes. How many milliliters in a tablespoon?
It's 14.79 milliliters.
Okay. Well, these bottles are 8.8 milliliters. So, according to the recipe, I'm not going to have enough red, but I think I will. I just got a gut feeling. All right, the texture is really nice. It's, I don't know, you can't really tell too much. Maybe you can, but it is like a nice, thin thickness. I don't know, it does kind of resemble blood, the texture at least. Okay, so I'm going to use this whole thing. I guess we'll start off with half, let's just see. Yeah, that recipe isn't right. Or I don't think it's necessary to do, what, be 4 tablespoons for this? It's looking pretty good right now. A little more red. Alright, I'm happy with how that's looking. But I do think it needs just a little bit of blue just to darken it up. We'll start with 3 drops. Yep, I'm glad I didn't do any more than 3 drops. Hopefully the colors are correctly picking up on the camera, because this looks awesome. Alright, yeah, so I'm super happy with how that blood turned out. That might be the best, like, realistic looking blood that I've ever made. And it's not going to be sticky, so that's a big plus. Dry this up real nice. Okay, so I don't have anything to make it perfect, especially with using food-based items, you know, edible stuff. I'm going to use a little bit of curry. And this is going to be such a quick shot. I think it'll be okay. And then a little bit of cumin. Mix that together. At least to get a little bit more of a pigment on there. And I can add more tomorrow. Yeah, that's even more yellow than I was hoping. I can't really rub it, because then you get a little bit of a, like a very outer layer of skin off. So, yeah, that's definitely too yellow, but I'll work on it tomorrow, let this kind of soak in.